SWI is a new MRI sequence which stands for Susceptibility Weighted Imaging, and it's exquisitely sensitive to the identification of calcification or hemosiderin in the brain. Hemosiderin is the final breakdown product of blood, and so SWI is the best sequence for identifying small, old areas of injury to the brain. Diffuse axonal injury refers to multiple different areas in the brain being affected by shearing forces when, for example, a patient is in a car accident and their head decelerates and their body is stopped by the seatbelt. The identification of those small areas of injury is quite difficult, and MRI is the best imaging modality for identifying them. So SWI is sensitive for the identification of hemosiderin, which is the final breakdown product of blood. The process of breaking down blood to obtain hemosiderin takes a certain period of time, days to weeks, and therefore, ideally, SWI is not done in the first few days, but rather several weeks or months later. The hemosiderin in the brain is trapped by something called the blood-brain barrier and stays in the brain for years and even decades, and so SWI can be sensitive to a brain injury which occurred a long period of time ago. The next best sequence for identification of blood is a gradient sequence, but SWI is far more sensitive than gradient sequences for this particular task. If you've had a car injury or other head injury several months or even years ago, your head CT will almost certainly be normal unless you've had a severe head injury. But even with a normal head CT or even with a normal MRI examination with gradient imaging, it's possible to identify areas of injury with SWI.